This is gonna be some unscripted right here. Hey guys, it is Sam Elliott Ryan here, back with another video, and today it is currently 12 a.m. and I just got this sudden spark of inspiration when talking to my best friend Henry on the phone because quarantine. He lives in Germany, so I wouldn't see him anyway. But anyway, we were talking about censoring things, like specifically triggering things. So I'm gonna kind of talk about that. I'm bringing back the Let's Talk series that I had back on my YouTube channel like a year and a half ago. So yeah, if you guys didn't enjoy that content, well, sucks for you. Don't watch it. Cause I'm gonna be talking about some stuff that like maybe you disagree with, and like I'm gonna try to be as respectful as I possibly can in these videos because it is dealing with some controversial topics. But yeah, let's just get into the video. So this is completely unscripted. I have nothing I'm following, so there's gonna be a lot of like pauses. Also there's gonna be a lot of noise because my chinchilla's in the background, chinchilla. No, she's chewing on a stick. Anyway, so censoring things. It's an interesting topic because obviously there are a lot of things that should be censored. Like, for example, if you, and I'm gonna have a trigger warning in this title, but if you didn't read the title, trigger warning, I'm gonna be talking about self-harm. Self-harm and suicide specifically. But anyway, so like, I'm on TikTok. Most of my following comes from TikTok. And I'm gonna plug my TikTok in the description. Please go follow it. I'm trying to get to 1,000 followers on my new account so I can go live because I'm not 16, which sucks, but yeah, it's asinine. But anyway, hi Stormy.
What do you want?
She's so cute. Okay, yeah, so I'm on TikTok a lot, and recently I saw a video come up, and I might save it and like put it in here if I can find it. Like, basically to like say like to not trigger you, and I completely agree. People shouldn't have to censor themselves, like their scars and stuff like that, because people can get triggered over that. People can get triggered over the smallest things nowadays, and it's not our job to make sure you don't get triggered. That's a thing you have to learn to deal with. You need to learn how to be like, oh, okay, I need to learn to cope with this. You need coping mechanisms. Talk to somebody and be like, hey, this is how these things make me feel. What can I do to not make me feel these ways? Or not necessarily make you not feel that, but help you cope with it better rather than wanting to relapse or something, you know? And so, scars are one thing. When you have fresh wounds, self-harm wounds especially, or videos of you cutting yourself, that is absolutely 1000% not okay. But like, it's one thing if you're like, oh, I'm a survivor, like, and like have like scars on your arm. And it's another when you're having a mental breakdown, posting a picture of your bleeding thighs or your bleeding arms. Like, that's one, disgusting. Nobody wants to see that. And two, it's extremely triggering. Like, that's not something we're gonna see every day. Like, there's a difference between falling on your knee and getting a scrape and bleeding. There's another between lines slit on your wrist, you know? And so that's not okay. Like, seriously, if you do that, stop. And like, I can say that because I was one of those people. I never posted it, but I'd like take pictures of it. And like, I wouldn't say I was an attention seeker, because that was my coping mechanisms. That was the only way I could cope with like my depression, is I wanted to feel pain, but I took pictures of it, and sometimes I sent it to people. And I look back and I'm like, wow, what a jack. Like, who the f does that, you know? So yeah, going back onto the scars and stuff like that. Scars should not trigger you. If anything, it would be triggering for the person that has them, but I wouldn't, like, if I saw somebody else's scars, I'd be like, good for you. like, not good for you that you self-harmed, because I would never condone that, but good for you that you've made it this far, you know? Like, I've always had mixed feelings about, like, posting about self-harm, like, in general. Like, people are like, I'm proud of my scars, and I've never said that I'm proud of my scars. I'm proud of how far I've come, and they're a reminder of the roadblocks that I've encountered, but I am not proud of what I've done to myself, you know? And the people that are like, oh, I'm proud that I did this, I'm like, what is there to be proud of, you know? But that's only the people that are like,
I'm proud that I cut myself, that I could, like, learn to deal with pain. And I'm like, no,
you didn't learn to deal with pain. Like, that's not a way to learn to deal with pain. Learning to deal with pain is going to a therapist and finding healthy coping mechanisms. And I might list some, like, links in the description. Like, obviously I'm gonna put the suicide hotline in the description, because videos like this, you need that. That, and I'll probably put some, like, self-harm alternatives, because I know I use those. Like, drawing on yourself with a red marker if you like the aesthetic of, like, blood. Drawing on yourself with red marker if you like the pain. Take an ice cube, like a dry ice cube, and rub it on your skin. Or not a dry ice cube, because that can rip your skin off. But an ice cube, and, like, rub it on your skin. Or take a rubber band and, like, pop your skin with the rubber band. Things that are less harmful. Those are, like, starting points, you know? And here's where I'm gonna get into the, like, I mean, I've kind of been controversial this entire time, but anyway. On TikTok, there's been, like, things where people are like, so I'm on Witch Talk, the witch side of TikTok, and Stormy, babe. And, people do hexes sometimes, which I do not condone, that's for another video. But they'd put, like, blades in it, and people would comment, like, make a trigger warning, and I'm like, why would you need a trigger warning? And they're like, the blades, and I'm like, I'm sorry, what? You're gonna see those blades literally anywhere. Like, if you go to the store, you're gonna see razor blades for shaving your legs. Or if you see a pencil sharpener, like, because that was the way I got my blades, was a pencil sharpener. If I were to see a pencil sharpener, I wouldn't be like, take all the pencil sharpeners out of here, it's not okay. Like, that's, no. Like, I need to learn to cope with that, and I have learned to cope with that, and that's something that's really important to me, that, like, I'm okay. Like, I can honestly say that, like, I can go watching most things without being like, oh, you know? When I see people cutting themselves, that's a different story. That definitely takes me back, and it triggers me a lot. But that's a different story for a different day. But no, people who are like, you need to put a trigger warning for a blade, or, like, the mention of self-harm, there needs to be a trigger warning. But I don't know. It's just, I don't know. And I'm, like, probably all over the place right now. I don't know. It's 12 a.m. I'm all over the place. I'm gonna edit this later, and I'm gonna be like, what was I talking about? This is Sam editing, and I can confirm that I'm like, what the fuck am I talking about? But yeah, just, like, be cognizant, but don't expect people to censor themselves for you. Like, yeah, just learn to cope. That's the most important thing, and I'm not saying it's gonna be easy. It'll be probably really hard, depending on what you've gone through. And honestly, everybody's experiences, there's nothing that bothers me more than when people invalidate other people's experiences. Like, if someone's, like, really depressed because, so, like, when I was in fourth grade, I became really, really depressed after a show I was in got canceled. I was depressed out of my mind. I was 10. And I wanted to die. And people were like, people have it so much worse than you, you need to get over it. And I was like, that's the worst feeling. Being invalidated. Like, man, like, that sucks. Like, stop. Like, it's just not okay to be like, oh, your experiences aren't as bad as mine, so you're not valid. Like, no, that's not how the world works. Everybody copes with things differently. And everybody, the way everybody copes, I wouldn't say it's okay, because it's not. I don't think self-harm is an okay coping mechanism. Anybody that does is not okay. I don't think there's anything, like, when people are like, oh, you shouldn't be depressed because you don't have it as bad as this person, or like, there are people in Africa starving, you shouldn't be sad because you can't graduate. Also, the whole corona thing is killing me, and like, people who are like, people are dying, Karen, like, I understand people are dying, and that's really devastating, but don't invalidate other people's feelings, especially the class of 2020. I feel so bad for the class of 2020, because they won't get to see their prom, or graduation, or their senior nights, or their senior walk. Like, you know, they're not gonna get any of that, and I feel so bad for them. Like, if this was my senior year, I would be devastated, whether I lost somebody to the coronavirus or not. Just because it seems silly to you does not make it silly to them. Like, it shouldn't be silly to them. I get it's killing people, and it's really scary. Like, what's going on right now in the world is very, very scary. But, and the people who are being irresponsible and going out and being like, oh, I'm not gonna get it, so, or like, if I get it, I'm not gonna die from it. Like, that's so irresponsible. Stop it. Like, just because you won't die from it doesn't mean somebody else you come in contact with won't die from it, you know? And that's super inconsiderate. So just like, guys, please be safe. Be careful. Social distancing is important. And like, I'm over here like, I want to see my girlfriend, and I want to see her so bad. But like, I've gone off on so many different tangents tonight. But overall, don't invalidate other people. Don't censor the world. Like, don't expect the world to censor it for you, like, itself for you. And three, please find better coping mechanisms than self-harm. Like, please, please, please. So yeah, that was my TED Talk. Thank you for coming. If you've stayed to watch this whole video, I really appreciate it. This is 14 minutes and 52 seconds. By the time I edit it, I bet you it's gonna be like 9-minute video. So that's fun. Woo, got a lot of editing to do. Okay, bye guys, I'll see you next time.